Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I'm Laura Boy, and I'm delighted to welcome you to this second edition of the MIPFormats Fresh Talent Pitch. But who better to tell you about what's fresh and new than a familiar face to everybody, Miss Fresh herself, Virginia Masler.
So always saying I'm fresh, I think I'm going to end in a blooper, but it's sorry. So our team at the WIT has been in charge of the difficult mission to select six brand new projects among over 100 applications. All these applications had to be projects that are not commissioned yet by any broadcasters, so it has been only pilots or projects, not even produced, and the WIT was chosen to select the format because we're a 100% independent company, research company. We're spotting all the new shows on TV and web TV around the world. We cover around 40 countries. So it means we watch approximately 600 new shows every month, and as we've been doing that for 15 years now, it means that we've seen more than 108,000 programs in my life, so that's why I'm not so fresh. But since I started the WIT, I enjoy television, and the challenge for these projects was to impress us, which of course is difficult, but we're still not bored after 15 years and more than 100,000 new shows. We're not bored. We still have a candid look at television, and in this MIP format pitch, we were looking for everything that was fresh. However, I think that freshness was not everything and is not everything. After all, maybe freshness was not the strongest criteria. For us, the main criteria was that the pitch should be appealing immediately. It should be understandable immediately. And as you can imagine, if we at the WIT did not understand the pitch immediately, if the pitch does not get to your point immediately, it's not the broadcaster that will make the effort to understand and to be interested in a pitch. For us, a good pitch was a very simple concept that takes no time and effort to understand, an idea that provoked an immediate pleasure, an immediate curiosity, attention, and that we could easily imagine or represent on a screen. It could be a TV screen or web TV screen. The quality of the demo was secondary. A pitch starts with a piece of paper, and I think that some of the applicants, of course, would benefit to have some training and good advice that they maybe could get at the Entertainment Masterclass. Finally, our philosophy at the WIT is to focus on the value of the content. In some cases, projects including strong transmedia, cross-platform, multi-platform mechanism, it was really impressive, but we wonder, but where is the pitch? Where is the TV show? So to our point of view, transmedia is great, of course, but a good TV show is even more enjoyable for the candid viewer that we still are. To conclude, we selected six projects from different genres, various universes, origins, that we think have a potential for fun, for pleasure, for curiosity for us as observers and also as candid TV viewers. But now the decision makers and the real professional, that I'm not, will put our proteges on the professional grill. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much again. I should just like to say there isn't just one, but two prizes to be won here today. The first is going to be awarded by Entertainment Masterclass. It's a scholarship award, and John Goh will be here later to tell you all about this. And then, of course, we have our MIPFormats Fresh Talent Pitch Award that our eminent jury members and seasoned format specialists will be judging en direct from MIPFormats in Cannes. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Annie Vigelius, David Lyle, and Colin Jarvis. Thank you. And now it's time to welcome the first of our fresh talent pitchers from Spain, Ramon Ribeiro and Eto Alonso from Bus Stop. Thank you, gentlemen.
Sorry. Good afternoon, everyone. Every time we create a new format in P52, we always keep in mind one requirement, falling in love with it. And to do that, it must have three characteristics. Telling a universal topic, being pure entertainment, and that you look forward to watching one more show after every broadcast. Just like when you first meet the love of your life. We know that these ones are the magic ingredients simply because they are just what we look for when buying and producing a format. When we created Bus Stop, we knew that we have just met our better half. It seems it has stolen Fresh Talent Pitch Jury's heart too. Thanks. And now we hope that it becomes that format which you all are looking forward to falling in love with. Welcome to Bus Stop.
Up until now, fallen in love was easy if you knew how. From now on, where also matters. Welcome to a new revolutionary way of dating that will prove that love has no frontiers. One candidate searching for love, three girls, one bus, and a different city every day with seven new girls. A single man embarks on a trip without a closing dates with three women ready to conquer him. Dates take place along the route until the next destination. Upon arrival, seven new women will be waiting for him. New dates in the city and three chosen girls to continue the trip. But also a whole country to travel and hundreds of lonely hearts waiting for love. Some buses and formats just pass once in a lifetime. We wait for you in Bus Stop.
As we mentioned before, Bus Stop tells a universal topic, love and dating. But it does so with a strong, versatile and interactive format. It's strong because it creates a great event in every city. Versatile because it can be easily adapted to a weekly show. And interactive because the candidates sign in the program's website. Let's have a look at the development. In every show, there are five very powerful script twists corresponding with the crucial moments. The first, the dates in the bus, and especially the time distribution of the three dates. How many kilometers, how much time will he devote for each of them? Will he dedicate the greater part of the route to only one girl? Besides, dates are watched but not listened by the rest of the mates. The second is the election via web of the seven new girls in the destination city by the single man. He chooses in the booth via computer between all the girls who sign in the program's website. Third, the elimination up on arrival in the city and in front of the new seven girls, what he must to do first is eliminating one of the three girls who travel with him. But the expelled girl at least has the opportunity to eliminate one of the seven female suitors. Fourth, dates in the city. The single man will have dates in the city with the other eight girls as he wishes. or one by one, in group, in a spa, in an amusement park, he chooses. And finally, five, a great moment at the end of the day is the crucial time when he has to decide which three passengers will travel with him until the next city. Will he finally choose one of the girls who he knew today, or some of those who were already in the bus with him? In short, an audition's gripping show, who will he choose? How many cities must he visit until finding his better half? How many broken hearts will be left behind? But it's also passion, a new landscape every day, new dates, night parties, arguments, fun, living together. A format easy to produce anywhere and really affordable. For further information, we can find us in audiovisual from Spain. And just remember, some buses and formats go past just once in a lifetime. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you, best up. To stay with us, please. Now, any questions from the jury here? Annie, for example.
What's going on in the bus?
Sorry?
What? I didn't quite understand. You know, I understand that they're going from place to place and that there are loads of women waiting for them.
I can't hear very well.
I didn't hear you either, which is a problem.
Maybe
that's
sound,
why I had
please.
To ask the question.
What's going on in the bus?
What's going
happening
on?
In
yes.
the bus?
What happens in the bus? What do we see? What, you know, what's...
From city to city.
No, it's just like what's playing out in the bus. I mean, they're going from city to city and they're picking up girls and they're leaving them behind. But in the bus?
Yes, in the bus, they're
we're
leaving.
Filming in the bus. What's
what's happened?
Yes.
Oh, sorry, because my English is not very good.
No.
I'm sorry. No. So what happened is the datings. During the route, there are datings. There are two rooms, one where he lives and the other room, the three suitors, female suitors, living. And he makes dates in his room. Okay?
Right. Mm-hmm. Okay. So, Colin, have you got any questions?
Well, is it an hour format or a half hour? Duration.
Sorry,
how long?
Speak? Yeah.
The show. How long is the show?
How long?
Yeah.
Strip once a week?
No, it's week. It's daily, 1 hour.
Daily.
Yes. 1 hour. Right. Okay. Well. Okay. Well, thank you very much. Maybe now we'll have some voting. Some voting. May we have some voting? Okay. So, Colin.
I voted...
Did you press, Colin, let us know?
Did I?
Yes. We'd like to see some lights. Great. Annie?
Yes.
Did you vote? Yes, you did.
And I voted no.
And David, any chance to see David's vote here? Right. Okay, so any quick comments? Annie?
Well... I don't know. It's a little boring since I'm the only woman on the panel that it would be me who voted no. But I do find it a little sexist, quite honestly. I think it's a Latin thing. I think it's a cultural thing. I mean, I commission about 3,000 hours of programming every year. This show will not be amongst the next year's 3,000 hours
I
of programming.
I should just say that Annie is from SVT, so from Scandinavia. David, any idea, any comments as well?
I worry that there may not be enough content for 1 hour daily. That I do think it'll be difficult, given that the dates on the bus in the rooms will basically, it's a sort of like a two shot in a way. I know they get out in the city, but I'm not sure that you could generate enough great content per day. Sorry.
But maybe they're on to the next Big Brother.
At least in Big Brother, you've got all those different rooms and people can run around and you can actually stage stunts and things. I wonder that the bus actually may constrict you more than it helps you in the end. That was my concern. sorry.
So, Colin, you liked it.
Yeah, I was the only one, wasn't I? the thing is, I think it's the wrong title. It doesn't say what the show is, Bus Stop.
Yeah.
I think Love Bus would be better. I think it does need...
Love Bus.
I think it does need format points. I think it needs kind of a little bit more structure. And I don't think, I mean, personally, that even the cost would be, in a sense, a daily. I see this more weekly. Yeah. But I think there's something there, but I'm kind of...
Some tweaking.
I'm convinced to say yes, as opposed to no.
Some tweaking. Okay, well, thank you very much, gentlemen. And see how the project goes. Thank you. And now let's welcome our second contestant, ladies and gentlemen. We have Uwe Stans from SEO. Welcome.
Hi, everybody. I'm happy to be here. Hi to the jury. My name is Uwe, I'm from Germany, from SEO Entertainment. We developed a new game show for the whole family. It's called Crosswords Coming to Town. I don't want to bore you with any more talking. This is the trailer, so enjoy.
A small town in the middle of nowhere. The public playground is closed. The youth center is a little run down. And a wonderful park doesn't exist. But the time has come for things to change. Crossword is coming to town. The market square is instantly transformed into a phenomenal game show location. This game show revolutionizes the famous Crosswords game. Crossword is coming to town is challenging entertainment for every age group. It brings action and fun into the citizens' and viewers' everyday lives and offers the chance to win 250,000 euros for town improvement. Let the games begin. We draw a huge crossword puzzle on a real market square in the town. We ask the community for the three smartest people around. The rest of the residents will play along as well. These are the three contestants who have to solve the mysterious puzzle with more than 30 questions. Ingrid, 36, a local business owner. Hans, 78, the village elder. Stephen, 17, always up to date. Business lady Ingrid has to choose from the numerous question fields. She picks number 7. Which European city is also called Venice of the North?
Stockholm.
She is right. The first letter of the mystery word is already solved. If the citizens manage to complete the word by the end of the show, they can win the amazing prize of 250,000 euros. Now, it's Stephen's turn.
Question 21, please.
What is the name of the British train robber who escaped to Brazil in 1965? Stephen has no idea, but his turn is not lost yet. Now he has the opportunity to pass the question on to his fellow citizens. And here comes the special part. Before the townspeople can answer, they must fulfill a challenging task. 20 volunteers have to paint the unsightly facade of the kindergarten in only 20 minutes. The countdown starts now. Meanwhile, the show continues with our three contestants. During this show, we get to watch numerous exciting stories about the town and its citizens and explore fascinating facts about music, literature, arts, science, education, law, religion, and bizarre and funny events. As the game continues, we will have a live conference with the kindergarten site. 20 minutes have almost passed. Success! Now, the painters can answer Stephen's question.
Ronald Biggs
is the right answer. As the crossword game continues, the puzzle fills up more and more, and the town becomes prettier. Every time the three candidates can't answer a question, the crowd needs to jump in and help them. Baking 10 cakes in 1 hour for the town's old folks' home. The mayor has to perform a bungee jump dressed only in his swimming trunks. For one challenge, a famous celebrity enters the town. Together with him, the citizens have to succeed in a very special task. Crossword is Coming to Town can be used as a weekly show or a great 60 to 180 minute event. The show that finally airs is a highlight montage from hours of fun and entertainment. And it brings new, exciting stories and characters to a great stage. Crossword is Coming to Town. Family entertainment at its best. Crossword is coming to town. Crossword is coming to town.
Thank you very much.
So, any questions? Colin, maybe something you'd like to ask Uwe.
In Germany, then, who would you think the broadcaster would be, a show like that?
In Germany, I think there could be, like, it could be the public broadcasters, ARD or ZDF, or it could be Sat1, which calls itself the most public broadcaster underneath the private ones.
And how long would it... How long would a record take? Because some of the stunts, the painting of the outside of the house, that kind of.
Yeah, it's not a live show. We have like more layers because when the guys start the painting, then we go back to the game. We go on with the game and we say it's like there are three actions at the same time. So there are three missions that you could cover. Otherwise, it gets much too much and you cannot follow the whole thing. And So what, this will be, it will have like live links at site.
What would a shooting day consist of? I mean, how many hours are you shooting to get down to a, we'll say, a 90-minute show?
It depends on the size of the crossword, of course. Let's say for a 90-minute show, I think we should record like 5 to 6 hours about that, and then it's a highlight montage, like the trailer says, and then you could take the best out of it and put the highlights together.
And Annie, have you got any questions here to add, or no?
Well, I would like to sort of more have a bottom line kind of question. What's the budget for a 1 hour weekly?
The budget?
Yeah.
We haven't yet set up the whole budget, but we were doing some research on how you can apply these crossword puzzles to the floor. There are different possibilities. I think the best one is, but of course it's the most expensive one, is to use like LED modules. But there could be other options, but this one would be a very elegant one. For the cost, I don't know. We have to go into calculation for that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, what do the jury think? So, David, what did you choose? No, sorry, Colin. Colin, okay. And Annie?
Are we going to motivate?
No, I'd like to see what you chose, color-wise, please. Thank you. And thank you, David, for your positive suggestion. So...
But hang
on. Yes, right. Okay, so just a few... So, Colin, you didn't like it so much.
I think
you had some doubts.
No, I think the biggest problem with it is the crossword.
Yeah.
If it wasn't the crossword, the kind of the idea,
I was prepared not to like it because I don't like crosswords, and crossword shows traditionally haven't worked. But really, the whole town is talking. It's a village show, and it's got challenges and stuff like that. The part I like least is the crossword, oddly enough.
Okay.
I would, but it's a nice hook. I get it. I don't think it's 100% there, but I kind of like the village play-along aspect.
Okay, so thanks
a
lot.
Yeah, I think I think crosswords are kind of boring, and I think this would skew pretty old, but I'm going to be kind to this one. Because, as you mentioned, you could probably sell it to a public service broadcaster, and quite frankly, there aren't that many formats being created for public service broadcasters. I didn't see a huge amount of commercial tie-ins or problems being a public broadcaster. So
you'd have to go and spray paint all the logos,
exactly, but we have to do that anyway. But I like the kind of sort of event thing. I think it could be a good summer show, but you're going to have to work on it so that it would be more, draw a kid's audience. I'm desperately trying to make my eight-year-old take an interest in crosswords, but it's,
But I'd go the other way. You want to actually, what you want out of a crossword is just a big on the ground thing. You should create your own board game, which after all, then you could own, and it could be your copyright, and then play it on the ground. It may have some letter crosswordy things in it, but it should have some sort of progression, like snakes and ladders or something or other, so the whole town can play different aspects of it. And then you can own the intellectual property, and then you get the apps, and life is good.
Okay, then that's good. Very good.
Thank you, David. Thank you, Annie. Thank you, Colin. And thank you very much, Uwe.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much indeed. Bye-bye. And now we would like to welcome our third contestant, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome to our joint venture team, Small World, Tim Crescenti and Marcus Toda from Media Factory with Dracula Tour Challenge. Whoa. Spectacular.
Good evening.
Good evening, good evening, good evening. I guess I didn't hear the microphone here.
Yes, a little bit closer, please.
Good evening, Colin, Annie, David, sir. And thank you, C21 and MIPFormats. We travel the world finding the most unique formats around the world, whether it's a dragon's den in Japan or the stuff we find in Thailand or the Aido guys in the Nordic part. And we have a new discovery from Romania, Media Factory, Marius, a.k.a. Vlad, in Monica from Media Factory Romania with their new show, Dracula Tour Challenge. But you've been sitting on your asses for a little bit, So it's time to get the blood flowing. Everybody stand up, stand up. You gotta stand up. That's it, stand up. It's audience participation. Look to the person to the left of you. To the left of you. Your other left. Now, bite their neck. You can go ahead and sit down, or unless you want to say, something else in Romanian. To get you further into the spirit, let's take a little bit of a history of the popularity of Vlad, the vampires, and Dracula.
He walked the earth over 500 years ago. He has played a role in 223 movies. He has donned names like Edward, Vlad, the Count, and Blade. But to everyone in the world, he is known as Dracula. Dracula is a household name, known and feared the world over. He has recently resurged back into pop culture through television shows and movie franchises. Dracula Tour Challenge is the adventure reality show set in the heart of Transylvania, the mythic home of Dracula and birthplace of vampire legend. Part fantasy, part adventure, part competition. Dracula Tour Challenge will push contestants to their limits as they fight to stay alive in the home of this spine-tingling legend. 9 brave pairs of contestants will travel from their home country to Romania. They will be transplanted into Transylvania, a land that has remained untouched by the hands of time and modern technology, where traditions and superstitions still reign supreme.
Well, vampires have never been more popular in the world. I think we've tapped into a pop culture explosion globally. We know that audiences love fish out of water, or as I like to call it, bat out of cave adventure series. And we're going to give the contestants a chance of a death time. We're going to transport them to Transylvania, home of the vampires and Dracula and all that good stuff. There, only one team will survive. and that one team will win Dracula's secret treasure. So they'll get to live the life of Edward and Vlad and Buffy. And you know, as we say, if you can't be in the book or the movie or the TV show, this is the next best thing. You know, we also tied in some merchandising too.
Dwayne, where's Dwayne?
We have vampire wine, Mr. Lyle. Vino. So, we want to tell you exactly how the show works. There's 10 episodes, 9 teams of 2 contestants. The contestants can range from?
From siblings, best friends, co-workers, or a parent.
Now, and everyone from true believers to the tough guys, or so they think. Right? And we're going to put them up in a little unique living arrangements. It could be a haunted, creepy castle. Could be part of the team will live in a medieval village. And the locations, we have the most stunning, scenic, historic locations that only we have the access to in Transylvania. Some of the locations?
Hunedoara Castle, where Vlad the Impaler grew up. Or we can shoot in the ruins of Poenar Castle, an abandoned castle built by Dracula's prisoners. The Bran Castle, the fabled home of Dracula. Fortress in Sighișoara is the city where Vlad the Impaler was born. And we can end the series at Dracula's graves, located on a remote island in the lake of Snagov.
So this is a really unique playground to have the most interesting, unique game show ever. But you need challenges. So quickly, let's go through the challenges.
Just a second.
And the challenges, by the way, anything from good and evil to zany and crazy.
Challenges could be like build coffins and dig graves, endure a feast for a vampire, escape from a coffin before sunrise, or finding vampires in a crowded environment.
This is the most unique format that audiences will truly sink their teeth into. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Don't go. So, right, the jury. How would you see this one?
So, 10 episodes.
10 episodes.
9 couples. And each episode, a couple is eliminated.
Yeah. Nine couples, 8 episodes.
Yeah. Would you like to move?
You just made that up, didn't you?
The idea of shooting situation should be 9 couples, 8 episodes. I mean, it's meant to go a little bit longer if need be. There's an elimination. We're going to eliminate one couple, one team each show. And the elimination can range too. Whatever the challenge was that in the finale of that episode will be reflective of how they're going to be eliminated. So it can be if it's the coffin one, the last one out of the coffin, well, they're the ones gone.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, Annie, have you any questions for us?
Is this one of these shows where you will have to gang up with a lot of other broadcasters and it's going to be extremely complicated and, you know, you have to be like 5 or 6 broadcasters doing this in this castle for it to make commercial, you know? Economic sense?
No, I think what we're trying to do is with what we did with Big in Japan, I Survived a Japanese Game Show, is create a turnkey production opportunity in Romania that makes it cost efficient. So you come in with your very, very minimal production team. All the other production resources are right there provided for you in Romania. So if your budget is going to be, whether it's Sweden or it's going to be Romania, it can bend and match as we did with the Japanese Game Show stuff.
David, anything you'd like to add?
The best sorts of formats, it's pretty straightforward. I do think it's a bit undercooked in the challenge department. And I think you would probably need to have 2 or 3 different events happening in that hour towards the big challenge or something or other. Mike, will the horror motif survive over 10 eps or now that you've done the sums, 8 eps?
We want to put in the romance, the sexiness, the good versus evil, the moral dilemmas, all those things we're going to throw in here so we just don't appeal to the Dracula, because that show would really suck.
Okay, well, maybe we can have a bit of voting here. So, shall we find out what David, Annie, and Colin thought of this? So, off we go. Colin.
Me.
Annie.
Oh.
Yes.
And David. Hey, guys. Full hand.
Share the meter.
So, yes.
I could always
pretty positive bored. Opinion for that. That's great. So.
I think that's quite okay.
Good, good. So, thank you very much indeed. And yes, see you soon. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, our next contestant is a French company called Little Nemo. I'd like you to welcome Frederick Mayer and a format called My Baby's Name. Thank you.
Annie. Colin, David, all names are probably one of the most intimate part of ourselves. Let's see how we can use that in a TV game show of 52 minutes in the promo.
I'm a baby girl. But my name is a secret, known only by mom and dad. It's hard to believe that I can speak at such a young age, but I guess I have a fresh talent. Do you want to know my name? Michael. Ashley. Matthew. Sophie.
Let's meet Alex. You wouldn't know by looking at her now, but she will have her first baby in the next 4 or 5 months. She has already chosen the name of her child, but nobody in the studio audience knows her secret. Alex is on stage now. When she tells us that she will have a baby girl, 100 girl names will appear on stage. Alex's baby's name is among them, along with 99 false names.
This is how I see my parents when I am playing on the ground. Don't you think they look like giants?
Alex will answer a series of questions related to names. Will she find the correct answer? If she gives the correct answer, she can erase 9 names from the list. If she needs 2 tries to answer, she can erase only 6 names. If she needs 3 tries to answer, she can erase only 3 names. When a name is erased, it will disappear from the studio stage. During the game, she will have 2 lifelines, as well as the help of her husband. At the end of the questions, hopefully, quite a number of the false names will have disappeared. Now, 100 members of the audience will vote to find out what the name of Alex's baby is. Some helpful hints are given to the audience. For each correct guess from the audience, Alex will win 1,000 euros for the future education of her baby. Family and friends are also invited to the show. Alex wants them to be there as she unveils the name of her baby for the very first time. An exquisite moment of family tenderness that we can share with them. Mobile applications and SMS votes are available for the TV viewers.
Now you know my name.
Hello.
Thank you very much. So, any questions from the jury
here? Still, here what we believe are the asset and the quality of this show. First of all, it's a family program with strong positive values. The TV viewers will have a strong empathy for the future mother. The voter in the audience will have some altruism to give the more money possible to the mother and the family. And because the family is together and the friends, it's a moment where you can share tenderness of the family. Also, you get strong emotional contestants and situation. We think that the lady which is waiting a baby is in the same time strong and vulnerable, so it's a very strong character. It's an innovative gameplay, interactive with an impressive studio design. You can get easy online application and SMS games. And at the end, it's a game show which uses the most intimate part of ourselves, which is our name. So my name is Frederick, mm-hmm. and thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. So,
Frederick.
Sorry.
Bonsoir.
Bonsoir.
For what time slot, what audience do you have in mind for this show?
I think it's a family program, and I guess it can be just before the news in France, which is 7 o'clock in the evening.
Access Prime?
7 o'clock in the evening. Mm-hmm. The Prime, just before in France, just before the yeah. news.
One part I didn't understand, and it was sort of crucial. The questions actually just reduce a lot of names. So you're left with anything from 10 to 6 names or something or other. And then how do the audience decide which ones they're going to vote for? How did they get a clue or a hint?
You have 11 questions, and you can erase 9 names per question. So you can erase in the maximum 99 names. Mm-hmm. So if she answers correctly to all the questions, there will remain only one. But because she will not answer correctly to all questions, maybe there will be 15 or something like that. So the audience will be given some hints. So this girl should like classical names, so this name should not match. And they will vote from the remaining names, maybe 15. And because you have 100 people which will vote, some will vote for a name and some for other name.
So if she does best, there are only a few names left, and so she'll get more money.
So obviously she has to answer correctly the question to have less possible name, so more chance to win.
Good.
Colin, any comments here?
No, I don't have any questions. I can't work out if it's a show or if it's a round in a quiz show.
Sorry?
I don't know whether it's a complete show. That the format is a complete 30-minute episode, or whether it's a section in a...
No, for me it's absolutely a complete show.
But in my mind I can't work if it's just a short, or it seems quite long to me.
Mm. Okay, so shall we have some votes? Dear jury. So, Colin.
It's because of that, really. I don't know whether it's kind of strong enough. It seems a little weak to me.
Mm. Annie?
Whereas the Dracula show was sort of a distinct, it felt some sort of distinctness about it, and tags on to the sort of retro trend of Fort Briard and whatever. This feels not retro, this feels a little old-fashioned. And I just didn't get engaged. I think I'm actually agreeing with you that I think it's possibly a daytime show, or a segment in another family show. But the idea is too small for an entire show at the moment.
And David, any comments?
I liked it because I don't know anything else like it. And I think, now, could the show be more exciting The packaging was gorgeous, which is a bit like telling an artist that you like the frame. But nevertheless, I thought it's going to an area, as you say, it's a very intimate area. Could it be more lively? Could it be more fun? Possibly. But I liked that the whole idea of people and names and wondering what the name of the baby will be is kind of cute. So there you go. Old sentimental fool me.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Frederick. Thank you. Thank you. And our fifth contestant, ladies and gentlemen, welcome, please, Alexandra Krug from Nguyen. And she's the head of formats with her latest project. On the Wave of Love.
Thank you.
Hello.
Bonjour. Hi, everyone. So before we start, excuse us for our little French accent. We are very proud to present you on the Wave of Love. So we are very proud to present you on the Wave of Love, brand new format from Nguyen. New because it's a dating with unique characters, seniors. Let me introduce you to the heroes on the Wave of Love. James, he's 60 years old. Sylvia, the beauty sleep. Catherine, she's 61. Christians, don't you think he looks like Steve McQueen? Renee, 62, she's an eternal dreamer. And Jane, the new French Miss Cougar. Do you think that their best days are behind them? We think definitely not. Sorry for my bad English. So why seniors in a reality? Because seniors are in numbers everywhere. In Germany, for example, 23% of the population is at least 60. In France, 20%. Because seniors are already stars of reality TV, among others. You all know them. Hugh Hefner, Sharon Osbourne, Susan Boyle. They proved us, by their strong personalities, that seniors can seduce a young and large audience. So, now, why seniors in a dating reality? Because seniors are healthy and have a right to love. We want to prove that you can find the true love at 60 or 7 years old and even after. And you, what do you think? Let's watch the trailer together.
Can we have the trailer, please?
Someone can help us, please.
Yes. Is there any chance of getting the trailer? Do we have a bit of a problem right now?
I think behind the scenes, someone can help us, please.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. What we can do during this time, perhaps a little happening, we can sing something, something like love dating. Love Boat? You know Love Boat? You want to sing with us? Love Boat! Please someone help me! Yes. Wow.
So, Alexandra, I don't know if you can go on to second part.
Thank you.
Saved by the Bell.
Healthy. Classy. Crazy. They have taken the world by storm. Singers. But if gray is the new chic this season, when it comes to love, age is still a burden for many. Until now. Make me feel like I'm living. On the Wave of Love is the first reality dating show for people over 50. A brand new format breaking the ageism taboo and proving that love knows no age limit and no frontier. Four colorful seniors will embark on the cruise of a lifetime. Dynamic, eccentric, flirtatious, romantic, they're all different, but they all share one common goal: find their soulmate. With the help of their relatives, each senior will handpick five potential suitors, from any style or any age, to come on board. For 3 weeks they will travel across the seven seas, and get to know each other through all kinds of romantic or daring activities and challenges, in the most exotic locations.
Wow.
But love can be a tumultuous journey. How will they react to the temptation of the young and sexy crew members? What will happen when they are suddenly confronted with a possessive ex-wife, or a former love crush? The heart has its reasons, and at each stop one of the suitors will have to leave the boat. Who will stay stranded on the wharf? Who will pursue the journey to its end? Touching, funny, eye-opening, each unique character will prove us, in its own way, that it's never too late to ride on the Wave of Love.
Yes. Worth waiting
Thank you.
For. Okay, do you have any?
We're very late, so I'm going to be very quick. Let's see now the key points of the formats. As you can see, the mechanics is quite simple because the set is a real cruise with real passengers on holidays. So all the seniors and the suitors will embark on the ship for 3 weeks. However, we imagine twists are happening in order to put spice in the program. The first twist is on each ship is that one surprise passengers will come on board. It can be a possessive ex-wife or indiscreet daughter, etc. And second, on the fourth episode only, one mystery suitor, one for each senior, will join the ship. It can be, for example, a former love crush, ex-girlfriend or boyfriend. We wanted to make this arrival, we wanted to balance the feelings already established during the show. And last but not least, the transversal twist present all in all the episode is the temptation of the youths. First, because the seniors can choose suitors from all ages, young and not that young. And secondly, because as you can see on the teaser, the crew members are young and sexy, and they will be very careful toward the seniors. So, well,
fun and games.
I'm sure you like it already. Actually, the crew members are not official suitors, but if one of the seniors decides so, they can join the competition.
To conclude, seven reasons to commission on the Wave of Love.
Well, it's new.
It's daring.
It's trendy.
It's funny.
It's positive.
It's rehabilitating.
And it's opportunist.
Thanks for your attention. And don't forget this summer
to ride on the wave of love.
Fantastic. Thank you. So
the hardest thing is now.
Any questions from the jury?
How many episodes are there out of the three-week cruise?
We imagine a series of six episodes of 70 minutes, and the cruise will doing 3 weeks. Sorry, you will have one episode, the first one episode, and the last one episode will be on the ground, and the fourth. Intermediary episode will be on the cruise. Do you understand?
Sort of.
Sorry.
Well, we imagine six episodes
The first episode and the last episode is on the ground, in their families, in the senior's family, and the other episodes, so four episodes, are on the boat, sail adventure.
At sea, yeah.
Okay. And anything? Oh, sorry, Colin.
Sorry, did I understand it right that it's open to all ages? So a younger person on the boat.
Absolutely. Yes.
When does it sail?
Thank you.
Okay, so, all right, any no comments straight away? Well, we'll go straight on to the voting and see what the jury thought.
Come on, David. You will have great fun.
I just... my concern is...
Don't be so concerned.
So, Colin.
I was going to be put off because I thought it was kind of older generation, which I think is less commercial, frankly, around the world. But I think if it's sort of women for toy boys, I'm on for that.
Yes, we want to have, also cougars and sugar daddies and...
Annie, what do you think of this?
thank you.
I think you're onto something here. It made me sort of think of Cocoon and
there's a song.
And parts of my own life. I think I don't agree, quite frankly. I think advertising agencies and commercial broadcasters alike are identifying this older segment of the audience as being commercially interesting. I wish as a public service broadcaster I could do this, but I can't. But I would love to produce it with you. I think you're going to have a lot of fun selling it. And I think you're going to have a lot of fun producing it. And I think you will sell it and you will produce it. And I think you should invest in it.
Thank you very much.
Yes, great. Like to vote, David, for us? Can we have... Yes! Have.
5 years ago, I certainly, and it's not about my age, but the advertisers would have killed it. You wouldn't be able to sell it to a commercial broadcaster, and it's a commercial show, because they just wouldn't put that on. Later on, I'm...
Can I
for your life.
You see, when, people are, young people are leaving television.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, yeah. So the people that will still be there in front of the television are these guys.
Yep.
So
that's why I said 5 years ago you wouldn't have a snowball's chance in hell. It is changing because now, it's interesting, I'm talking to Dick DeReich later on, and he's talking about the percentages of people watching TV, and you're right, the young people have fled, and broadcast TV. And so the advertising agencies who used to be ridiculously aimed at 18 to 39, believing that the baby boomers who were spending a fortune were not affected by advertising, would, I think, be interested in something like this. But you'd have to, I think some of those analogies you made to Benidorm Bastards and things like that are important. I think you really need to keep the comedy high, and I think possibly the amount of sexual rolling around, I'd keep that somewhat low, because that might put people off their food.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Alexandra. Thank you very much, and best of luck with On the Wave of Love.
After having your tape breakdown, you need it.
Okay, now we have our last contestant, and I'd like to welcome, if I get my paperwork right, the last contestant, I'd like to welcome Notorious Entertainment with a format called The Queen of Style, and Ole Osenbroyer is going to present it for us.
Hello, good evening. My tribute to the masters of the MIPFormats. Okay, my name is Ole Osenbrücker. I'm from Munich. My production company, my small company, is called Notorious Entertainment, and I've got a passion for formats.
My challenge was to create a new format that is adaptable for all media channels and internet platforms, a format that attracts a wide female audience, the most wanted target group out there, a format that features an entertaining trend, a format that builds a forum to integrate content-motivated brands, and I don't mean simple product placement, and a format that provokes headlines by using celebrities as contestants in a new form of competition. The trend I chose is celebrity fashion. Why? You all know that fictional shows like Desperate Housewives, Sex and the City, or Gossip Girl have created new style icons and a new awareness for fashions. Worldwide, fashion magazines, tabloids, blogs, and entertainment programs are using this trend to turn their readers, users, and viewers into fashion victims. They are showing good style to awaken our desires. And, of course, they also expose bad style to make us laugh. No matter what they wear, every woman, and especially celebrities, think that they have great personal style. But if having good style is a talent, then why not make a talent show out of it? This is my format vision. In each territory, we're taking upcoming, wannabe, and even have-been celebrity ladies as contestants in an entertaining competition full of headline-making catfights and drama to find out who will become the new national queen of style. There is no age limit for the participants in this format because it's about style and taste, not about beauty and youth. In different fashion challenges every week, the contestants must create looks to impress the jury and the viewers, while our cameras follow their struggle for perfection. For example, they must reinterpret iconic looks of the past. Each week, they also have to create a different female three-piece basic look on a limited budget. And they have to put together glamorous outfits for the red carpet events that they are attending the upcoming week. In every episode, the challenges can be tailor-made to feature specific trends, labels, or products. The contestants are judged by a big name in the fashion industry who seeks the TV limelight and wants to follow people like Tommy Hilfiger or Tyra Banks. Maybe a TV fan like Jean-Paul Gaultier or a duo like Dolce & Gabbana or the boys from D Squared. For Italy, I could also imagine an Harris from the clans of Missoni, Biagiotti or even Versace. Also legendary models such as Kate or Naomi could take a step beyond the catwalk into completely new roles in TV. Look at what Heidi Klum has achieved in her career now. The prominent stars and the innovative TV show profit from each other at the same time. Why? Both generate new awareness and publicity with this project. Queen of Style is a format that can be adapted to all your needs, no matter what platform or budget. The format can be a classic 8-week primetime series with elimination ceremonies every week. Which of your selected 10 celebrity ladies wins the crown of style? In this version, viewers are voting for the winner in a spectacular live final. But the format can also be a fashion online soap, starting virally on the internet with only 5 celebrity contestants in 20 short episodes. This version is also perfect for online distribution on smartphones and tablet PCs. Whatever you need, the show is the perfect stage for brand integration. For example, by using department stores or shopping malls as locations. Imagine retailers that have to compete with growing internet businesses turn the stores into trendy sets for celebrity shopping extravaganzas. You see, Queen of Style is an innovative and entertaining reality format that really celebrates shopping. And therefore, it is a new platform to integrate content-motivated brands, stores, and products. And of course, it's interactive. Viewers can vote for their favorite celebrity and the best outfits. They can even order every featured piece of fashion by clicking on the tagged products. Viewers can also upload their own looks to share them with the Queen of Style community. Providing an opportunity for self-expression like this is key to online success nowadays. Being a style icon on the red carpet, in media, and in stores, that's a female dream. We can make it a successful format for broadcasters, for brands, and for territories who share this vision.
Thank you very much. So, any questions? Thank you very much indeed. That was fantastic.
So, if you had your, if you controlled the world, which one of those 25 different options of ways for it to be programmed would you like to see happen?
I think at the moment everybody's looking for the big thing in the internet, a reality format that really makes it out of the net onto the big screen. I think a sort of branded format like this is hard to sell on private television at the moment. That's the results that I have from the German market. But I think on the internet, everything's possible, and the brands are completely flexible because they can decide about the budget, they can decide about the celebrities, and they are really part of the deal, and they get much more from it than booking a classic expensive spot on television.
Annie, yeah. No, go ahead.
No, I think this is interesting, but I wonder, because if you want this to be an internet or a blog drama, you know, exclusively made for the web, then I wonder, if you want this to be, you know, to be a web drama or a blog drama or a docudrama, reality show, maybe a small format, could be extremely flexible, it turns out. What is it that you have? I mean, if we would do this with you, we would, you know, we would probably start on the internet, we would do a 15-minute docudrama, reality, fashionista thing. What would you own? Because the title sort of, excuse me, sucks. No, but you could have called it.
I mean, Queen of Style is just a synonym.
No,
for
I didn't mean to be facetious, but I think you're onto something super interesting. But I'm wondering whether you have thought through the sort of what is the format? What is it that you have? What is it that you bring? To have you, you know, what?
I must admit that one of the. I'm sorry, one of the classic things not to do in a pitch is give the buyer or whoever you're pitching to too many alternatives. You've actually got to go in and tell them what you're doing. Then if they're a bit interested, you can say after you've absolutely hooked them on what it is you're talking about, you can say there are some excellent apps and iPads and things, but if you bombard them with, it could be half an hour, it could be 90 minutes, it could be online, it could start, it's sort of like, I mean, my concern is I don't think there's enough there. I can see all the applications, I think it's a good area, but I don't know what the core asset is,
exactly,
in my view.
I think
exactly
the core essence of it, it's about celebrity ladies in your territory that you all know, and that come from different backgrounds, the young model from maybe some sort of talent show to an old elegant lady, and they all can compete each other, and it's about who of them is the new national style icon, if you don't like the word title, yeah. Queen of Style. And my basic vision was to do this in a big primetime show like Top Model in Germany or something like that. But my new vision, and this is what I wanted to make clear for this MIPFormats stage, is that you can also do it in small bits. You can start it virally on the internet, because then the budgets are small. This is really something to try out, and if it works, you can make it grow. And if it's, you know, successes from internet always have to grow. They have to start slowly, and then there is then they rise. And this is what I wanted to make clear with this vision. This, it has got a perspective where it can go to, but you can start it with a basic budget, and you can adjust it to the needs of your brands. I mean, you could even do it with a telephone company who wants to sell more of these new iPhones, and you say, okay, this is an online soap that our female buyers of the new iPhone get every week as a bonus or offer, something like that. Everything's possible with this thing, and this is what I wanted to make clear, because I think, especially when we're talking about branded entertainment, you have to be flexible, and that is what I wanted to make clear.
Fantastic. Colin, I don't think we're going to have any time for our next question. So now can we go on for the voting? Jury, how did you see the Queen of Style? Colin?
Oh. Should we vote?
I'm very torn.
Annie? And David? How cheating. David, yes, no, yes, not working.
Not yet.
Not yet, not yet.
Oh. Who are we waiting for? Me?
Yes.
Oh, David, sorry, I thought
David,
I hadn't voted.
Oh, David. So, right, just a few quick comments because we're going to have to move on a little bit.
Should we comment? I decided to be nice because I was so cruel to you just now. And I think, you know, what you have to, I like the idea. I think, you know, the problem is that you haven't explained what the it is, because everybody in this room can now go home and call their local gossip magazine. And I got this great idea when I went to MIP. And, you know, so you have to really quickly go home and create a partnership with some, you know, Cosmopolitan or whoever, so you can come with the it thing. And then we'll listen.
I will next time.
Okay, thank you very much indeed. Thank you very much indeed, Ola. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to choose the best of the best. So our jury will deliberate in the backstage and tell us who's going to be the MIPFormats Fresh Talent Pitch winner. Thank you very much indeed, members of the jury. Colin, yes, we'll be back. And as I said earlier this evening, there are two prizes here, and I should like to invite John Goff to join us on stage to announce the EMC Entertainment Prize winner for the evening. Thank you, Jill.
Good evening, Laura.
Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, EMC speakers, EMC alumni, EMC future speakers and future participants, good evening and welcome. This is the moment when I'm going to announce the winner of the Entertainment Masterclass Scholarship for our 2011 program, which starts in Berlin in June. Candidates for the scholarship came from those finalists who put forward a concept to pitch here today. Yesterday evening, the Scholarship Selection Committee met to review all the applications, which was a very hard task, as you can imagine, having seen the pitches that have been here today, a very talented group of individuals who put forward their applications. This Selection Committee's task was to choose a candidate for the EMC who met the broad criteria for participating in the EMC programme for 2011, not just to consider the value of their format concept, which you've seen pitched here today. A candidate, in fact, who could join that select group of talent who will be the class of 2011. Before I announce the selection committee's choice, let me briefly underline the place of the EMC within our entertainment business. The EMC was created 4 years ago for the industry and by the industry. It's an education and training program that brings together the great, the good, the interesting, the inspired, alongside emerging talent, which are our participants. We have 20 days within the year, which is divided into four modules, 5 days each, held in four different locations across the world. By now, I think that the EMC has marked its place in our industry. It's now legendary, and its business-to-business network is second to none. For those of you that have not yet met the EMC, this leaflet is available in your MIP bags, and we do have a stand here for you to find out a little bit more. But with no more ado, it is my great honor to announce the winner this year of our third scholarship. And the winner is Uwe Stantz.
A round of applause, please. Thank you.
Uwe, well done. Thank you. My pleasure. My pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you and congratulations. A very fantastic proposal. Thank you. Would you like to say just a couple of words? Thank you very much.
John, thanks a lot. I feel honored. I'm looking forward to meet the people there, the participants and the mentors as well. And I'm looking forward to that, so thanks.
Thank you very much indeed, Uwe.
Thank you.
Crossword is coming to town. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you, Laura.
Thank you very much indeed, John. And now let's find out who's won the MIPFormats Talent Pitch. So Annie, David and Colin, can I ask you to join me on stage and hear your verdict? No, to the lectern, please, yes. I'm going to ask you to stand for this very official announcement. David, Annie, are you going to... No, Colin.
It's me, yes.
It's Colin who's going to announce.
I went to the loo and they decided it was me as I came back. Look, we want to congratulate all of the six contestants and contenders here because it's daunting enough to do a pitch in front of six or eight people. To do it in front of all of you, and need us, in most of them, not their mother tongue. So I think, for all of them, a round of applause.
Thank you very much.
But our decision was unanimous, I think it's a great show. I hope it gets traction. I hope it gets made. I can announce the winner of this year's MIPFormats Fresh is a show called On the Wave of Love from New and France.
Thank you. Alexandra, would you like to come back and join us?
Well done. Congratulations. Anyone who sings when the tape goes down deserves it.
Well done.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Not at all.
Very well deserved. Thank you very much. And I know that you guys are going to get together and have a good chat to how to put the project. Get the project
I think
forward.
Annie's about to order. Yeah,
I'm going to leave my job and go on the boat with you,
Alexandra.
Guys.
Would you like to say a few words, Alexandra?
Come on, Maiji. So we are very happy. So thank you very much, and thank you very much for your reaction during the trailer. We are very happy because when Marie-Julie, she's 27 years old, proposed me to develop a reality with old people, my first reaction was, you are crazy, it will be too difficult to sell to a broadcaster. I was an ex-broadcaster, so I know what the difficulty is to sell such a thing. But I think we found the way to transform it in something trendy, funny, it pushed the limits of the edge, and we think it could be a very good thing for the society. Perhaps you want to say something?
Well, I have. I just want to say thank you. Thank you very much. It's a chance to work with open-minded person like Alexandra, that hear your ideas. And I think it was the good time to show not old people but seniors on TV. And I think yes, it was the time. So
just one last word. We have a buff on the MIP, new wind distribution, booth 0601. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
And before you leave, ladies, can we just have a quick photo with Lauren Gaud, who's director of the television events at MIP TV? Yes, please.
We'll
photo.
Stand
yes. Can you come further forward?
Either yes. Side.
Yes.
There you go.
A little bit further.
I just wanted to say congratulations to the winners. Thank you to the jury.
Oh, that's all right.
Our partners.
Thank you, Lauren. Thank you.
Stand either side. There. You stand either side there. Yeah. Like that. No, you're in the middle.
Thank you, David. He's used to these things. Okay, now. Thank you very much.
Story. That tonight's gonna be